music.
And ever more to the year again. Alongside the Pocketings Media TV. We set the trend. Talk the truth, keep it real. No care who you be. We no beg friend. Put a stop to crime and violence. Pocketings Media TV again. Make Jamaica a better place to be. It's up to you and me. No matter how hard, we will break free from the pain and misery. United we stand together as one in love and harmony. So let's do this together with Pocketings Media TV. Ooh, yeah. With Pocketings Media TV.
You as a subscriber, one more murderation in a St. James. You see me, I say, Saul Springman slain in front of kids. Viewers and subscriber, we are jump right into it. You see me, I say, gunmen snuffed out the life of a 26-year-old man in full view of three children in Salt Spring, St. James, on Monday, spraying him with bullets during a brazen daylight home attack. Viewers and sub, as you can see on the screen at the house, that, you know, yeah man, brazen brawling in a brawling middle day, man, them shooting man star John, no star Pitney, then did they turn up and watch, you know, and see every damn thing when I see a place I run. This is why our Jamaican kids are so traumatized, because they are now privy and now exposed to these violence, you know what I mean?
The deceased has been identified as Daniel MacDuffus, also known as Dan, a superintendent attendant of Church Lane in Meggy Top section of Salt Spring. Garnet Nicholas, the deceased father-in-law, told the Star that the MacDuffus death has come as a huge blow. John No Star, you remember saying quotation, Jaja. Him is like a father to my daughter, three children them. And the children them, they're right beside him in the house when them shoot him up, said Nicholas. The children them traumatized. Is this the first time experience such a wicked act? And the children them did very close to Dan because he take good care of them. Nicholas said that he was about to head over to Mark Duffus' house when he heard explosion. So he heard a whole heap of gunshot reload, you know. You understand? Hear what I'm saying, do now? At first, me hear them out at the road. Then me hear them in the yard. A little after that, me daughter come and ask me, say me, don't know what going over there, so we'll pa shooting and them shoot done. Nicholas said, adding that he ran over to the house immediately to find a blood-covered MacDuffus lying beside the bed with the children next to him, staring in shock. Right there, so the kids them exposed to everything. So the kids them, they right beside him, seeing this man dead, you know, viewers and subscribers. See the man in a pool of blood and the kids them lie down or stand up right there. So I look in a shock. No kids, no little children should be exposed to them thing. Not in this earth. You understand? Because this have a long lasting effect on their mental and their psyche. This nago left them. They more constantly know what really did go on, you know, and them lose this person, you know. According to police report, shortly after 9 a.m., a group of heavily armed men invaded a section of Meggy Top and opened fire at the resident and several premises. They then walked to Church Lane, where they shot MacDuffus inside the small board dwelling house. Easily then kick off a little door, man, because when you know say a little board house and like a zinc up place and things, star. Very sad, star. Where this man I could have with them a man, when could I do now? Make them eat him and one deal with him so wicked. A wagwan now. Duffus was transported to Cornwall Regional Hospital, where he was pronounced dead. A police source told the Gleaner that based on information they have gathered, the shooting is linked to an ongoing gang feud in the community. Me no say something like that, you know. It could never be nothing else but gang feud. So this man can't catch this man good as all him son or anything can involve in a certain little things. I don't know Jamaica run around and can't catch Kwaku. Them are gonna catch him shot. Them gonna go for his mother, his father, or anybody were close to him. I saw the gang feud thing going on. I want you guys to know that, you know. You understand? Hear what I must say again now. The Salt Spring murder comes sharply on the heels of another deadly shooting incident in Mount Salem community, which is still under the Zone of Special Operation Security Initiative. Remember, I did that yesterday. I did the incident yesterday about that same Mount Salem shooting. So now see everything I tie up right there. So a bug of bad blood I go on. Whole heap of crazy thing I go on in the St. James area and of viewers and subscriber. Let me go on the details of what they must say.
Reports are that about 8:25 p.m. on Sunday, 23-year-old Daniel College Man Lawrence of a Clark Street address got into an argument with another man. During the argument, the man brandished a firearm and opened fire at Lawrence, killing him on the spot. The killings bring to 72 the number of persons murdered in St. James since the start of the year. So 72 people drop out right there. So in a St. James viewers and subscriber. Just a little argument, man start fight, man name back out gun, a man back out gun, and open fire. In a December man we named Daniel, also known as College Man. So the thing get really serious on the yard now. You can't even laugh up with a man too tough, you know. You can't really you know, joke thing with nobody, you know. The thing get wicked. Now, I could move on to our next little thing, you know, where after a long time, I know so that something I mash up Jamaica, you know. Yeah, man, you see, bleaching cream. There's a lot of bandoli thing I go on with these products, you know. The bleaching cream, you know. Here what I must say now, Chinese national charge for bleaching cream. Viewers and subscribers, a lot of these products should not be in Jamaica because these products are illegal. They are toxic. They are not good for the human health. You know what I'm saying? These products, them bleach out the melanin out of your skin and expose you to the sun ray, which is ultraviolet, which can cause cancer. It resulted in cancer. So Jamaican people must refrain from using these products. A long time, them something have to stop. Some of the big artists, them, some of the favorite artists and some other people, I use them and I influence you them for bleach out their skin. You understand? I would know where to come from. People have psychological problems in regards to lighter skin. People feel better when them skin lighter and bugger things. What is about discrimination go on to? It come from slavery days. When you know about the house Negro and the field Negro, you know what I mean? The lighter skinned persons used to be invited in the house and get better treatment, while the darker skinned person after the out they are called sugar cane. So them think they come on from them long time there. Even Spicer do colorism what the bugger sitting, so you know far that something come from. Alright, sir. Now the Chinese them now I capitalize on it and I sell the bandolo one them to the Jamaican them. If it's stopping, you know, this thing must stop right now, viewers and subscriber. You see me, I say, paper goes on to say, viewers and subscriber, a Chinese businessman was yesterday fined 610,000 or faced 9 months imprisonment for being in possession of 9 boxes of bleaching cream. You understand? Jin Wan pleaded guilty to breaching the Pharmacy Act when he appeared before senior parish judge Laurie Ann Cole Montague in the Kingston and St. Andrew Parish Court. But listen, look at charges when they might get a little monkey charge, you know, a baby charge they might get, you know. You what they might say, more get 9 months for them a dangerous product, yeah. No, man, a joke thing this. Let me continue still. The court heard that one was found in possession of 9 boxes of bleaching cream, which is prohibited under the Pharmacy Act. He was ordered by Cole Montague to pay a fine of 610,000 or face 9 months imprisonment for the bleaching cream. One was admonished and discharged on the charge of being in possession of uncustomed goods. A joke charge, he might get joke punishment, you know. Whole pa years in shall get behind bars for this. You understand? All this a Chinese money I got to write here now is pay the little fine. I add a more product. A matter of fact, the products them up on the way right now, I come back for replace them one where police then catch them with. Because the charges them is too small. They might forget whole heap of jail time, you know. You understand? The Jamaican government must make sure, say, people get a fair warning when they charge them for some little things. And a joke thing. Let me jump to the next incident now. Nurse assistant charged for fondling 15-year-old. I did this story, I think, maybe yesterday or the day before. This look a dirty boy, you know. I claim say him a nurse assistant. I mean, know very well that a nurse assistant, them good nurse assistant, them in a Jamaica now go on with them something, you know. This a boy, I get nurse assistants bad name. Viewers and subscribers, the good nurse assistant, them now go on with them arms house business, yeah. Here where boy go on with now. The male nurse assistant accused of sexually assaulting a 15-year-old patient at the Noel Holmes Hospital in Hanover was charged on Monday and is slated to appear in court on Wednesday. The accused has been identified as 45-year-old Damian Bigby
of an Hanover address. He is facing a charge of indecent assault. Reports are that the 15-year-old student was admitted to the Noel Holmes Hospital on May the 19th after she reportedly ingested pills in an attempt to commit suicide. Jaja. And at the same suicide thing lead her to the hospital and her viewers and subscriber because she get touched up at home by some family member. Now she run to the hospital and forget help and that this happened to the little girl, you know. According to the allegation, Big Boy fondled the girl while she laid in bed around midnight on May the 21st. The child reported the incident to the nurses and her mother the following morning. The mother then made a report to the police, who arrested Big Boy on May the 24th. The Western Regional Hospital Authority launched an investigation in the incident. So when I see the little girl, I'm not safe in a Jamaica right now. So I'm going to a dirty pervert when I see a circulated place and I run up and down in a place right now. The little girl, them in a serious problem. But at the same time, I like how the police then lock up your little dirty blokey Lagos. I want the judge deal with him real nice, you see. When I say real nice, I want the judge sort him out properly. Give him a nice piece of sentencing. You know? But I ramp with this boy, you know. You understand? Because it caused so much trauma to the little 15-year-old girl. We're already being traumatized from home and I try to escape from it. And this is like a nasty nigga, yeah. Go on with this, senior. Yeah. When I go and bless up on yourself, senior, we know say a bag of things media TV up and running. Like and share, man. Support the platform. Bang, 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 bang.
Bag of things media TV, man. Thank you for watching. Make sure you share it. Make sure you subscribe. Press that notification bell to stay updated, man. Jamaican assassin killing all names. Urban legend. Jackal out.